I'm at the hospital for my weight loss surgery, and I'm terrified right now. I'm here alone because Alan got sick, and so he couldn't come today. But I got here okay, and Dr. Now was pleased with the weight loss I've had over the last month. So he's moving ahead with my surgery today. I've worked hard to get this second chance. And without it, I have no hope for a future at all. So I have to get this no matter how terrified I am.
Today we're attempting to perform a gastric sleeve on Vianey. Her tests all look good, and she lost another 44 pounds over the last month, putting her at 482 pounds, which means she's under the 500 mark for the first time in almost 20 years. Okay, let's start. So she's still making good progress, and she has proved to me she's ready to have this operation today. But even though Vianey has lost over 120 pounds, at this point, she's still over 400 pounds. We can turn the room light off. And doing any surgery on a person this size is extremely high risk because of the enormous strain their body is already under with their weight. So any additional strain, no matter how small, could push their body to a point where it is too much and it starts to give out. So if there are any issues that concern us, we will have to stop the surgery early. But if we are able to successfully complete her gastric sleeve today, it will help Vianey to stay on track like she needs and lose even more weight. Because the sleeve gastrectomy is an operation that we remove 80 to 90% of the stomach, leaving a small narrow tube that looks similar to a sleeve. So the patient's food intake is physically limited. So this operation will give them an opportunity to lose even more weight.
Go a little bit higher.
I don't like what I'm seeing on the monitor. Her body is not handling the strain.
Okay, flatten table.
She's about to start coding. Her heart is stopping.
Room lights on.
We need to pump on the chest.
I don't feel pulse. Start their compressions. I don't feel pulse. Get the crash start going now.
Okay. Same here, guys. Go.
I need an arc line stat.
Give another Epi's
going in. Epi and Epi are both enjoying your charting.
Okay. I need a second person on round for chest compression.
All right.
We're working on airline over here. All
right. Get this out of the way. I need pads.
Pads are on.
Check for a pulse. Keep compressions.
I got you. I'm gonna take a blood pressure.
Yeah, I got a good pulse too.
Yeah, okay. We're doing well. Okay, it's under control.
While attempting to do Vianey's gastric sleeve procedure, her body started to struggle from the strain, and then her condition started to decline rapidly until her heart stopped. So even though all her tests were good prior to the surgery, the strain of all the weight someone this size has on them means their body could hit its limit at any point and start to struggle like this. And in Vianey's case, her pulmonary system wasn't able to handle the operation right now. So we immediately revived her and stabilized her. And right now, we're waking her up and putting her out of anesthesia to get her to recovery so she can rest. Because it's gonna be too risky to attempt to complete her operation today.
Relax.
We get cardiac enzyme.
Let's send cardiac enzyme, then let's go to the ICU, then watch her overnight.
No, she's stable.
No chest pain, no shortness of breath, pressure is good.
All right. You doing okay? All right. We have to stop the operation because your pressure dropped and your heart stopped for a few seconds, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but we didn't do the surgery.
No.
But you're doing okay. We have to stop the operation, okay?
Yeah.
You're gonna be all right. You didn't get the operation because your heart stopped for a few seconds, okay? All right? All right, you're gonna be okay, all right?
It's disappointing she didn't have surgery.
They started, their heart stopped. We need you here. We can always go back and do the surgery when you're a little bit more stable, okay? We can't do it if you're gone. So it was our choice to let you go or keep you. We decided to keep you, okay?
You're gonna be all right, okay? We just have to make sure everything's okay, all right? I know Vianey is very disappointed that we weren't able to complete her gastric sleeve, but the risk to try again today would be unacceptable, since it's clear her body is already struggling. The only reason we were even able to pull her out of her situation without any lasting damage is because we were monitoring her very closely, so we were able to react immediately. But if her system was pushed any further, it could have been too much for her, and she wouldn't have made it. For years, she had a significant amount of excess weight on her body, putting a great deal of strain on her whole system. And Vianey is at a point where her system is starting to give out. So it's going to take more time to try and build her health and stamina back up before we can attempt to do this operation again. So it's very important we work with Vianey to help her continue losing the weight, to not only get to that point, but to also reduce the strain on her system, since it's obviously at its limit and ready to give out any day, because she needs to lose as much weight off of her as possible, as quickly as possible. But unfortunately, weight loss surgery is not an option for her to do that right now.
I'm even mad that Dr. Na brought me back. I was like, he should just let me go.
You'll be fine.
Vianey has been home from the hospital about 4 weeks now. When she called me and told me what happened to her, I was so scared, but I was too sick to go to her. And Dr. Na kept her there overnight to make sure she doesn't have any other issues. But I just want to be with her, so I was really happy when she got back here. But she's been really sad about not getting the surgery.
I'll get you dinner, okay?
When I woke up and found out I hadn't gotten the surgery, it was life-shattering. And that's one of the worst and most defeating feelings I've ever had. I'm just really struggling right now, and I don't know how to get past it.
I miss my carbs.
I know, baby.
Sick of protein.
I feel like I don't have any motivation to be active or to do the diet. It's just taking everything I got right now to keep going. Dr. Now told me I had to because my heart is starting to give out from the strain I've put on it for so many years. So I'm pushing myself as hard as I can to stay motivated. But it's hard because I feel no matter how hard I work and what I'm able to do, in the end, I'm just condemned to live like this until my weight ends up killing me. All right. And I can't do that.
It tasted like crap to me.